What we do here is go back.
Hey, it is Monday, March 6th, and you're gonna come along with me on my day. Today, what we're going to do is we're going to go hang out with my sister and my dad this morning out at my parents' house. And then we might do some shopping because it's spring and I cannot believe how much Luke's legs are growing. Every time I put a pair of pants on him, I'm like, oh my gosh, they're too short. So I think we're gonna do that today. Come along on our day with us. So we're off to Grampy Brown's and Sarah's house. We got Lukey ready to go in the back seat, ready to hang out.
Can I have it?
You want to do some filming today?
Yeah.
You can. Maybe later, okay?
Maybe later.
And I'm ready for another coffee. So luckily Sarah has a pot on. My Keurig wasn't working, which is kind of a bummer. I think Elizabeth is teething. We were up late last night and she seems to be a little bit off today. So I'm definitely in need of another coffee. Should we go get a coffee at Grampy's house? Do you think he has any good snacks for us? Yeah. You think he has good snacks?
Can I see your picture?
Those are cool, Luke. Those are a good option. I like all, look at this moto jacket. So cute. Oh, these are cool too, Em. Look at these ones. They're like the moto style. Everything's like the moto. Hey buddy, come on out. Hey Luke, we're not playing in there, okay? It's time to go inside for a nap, so step out, okay? Do you want to hold my hand?
No, I can do it.
Okay, you do it. We are back from the mall, and looking for pants for Luke was very unsuccessful because I was looking for some deals, and they had so much cute stuff for spring at H&M, but there wasn't really any deals or sales. So I think I'm probably gonna check out Carter's and Joe Fresh later on this week.
Mom, go do it. Mom, go to the house.
We're gonna go to another store later this week.
Okay.
Okay, let's get the stuff out of the car. Come on. Mom will get Lizzie. Will you go open the door for me? So we'll go to another store. It is beautiful out today. So we're gonna go in the house for some naps and some snacks. And then we will probably go for a walk later. Emily got me this awesome hat earlier in the week, so she gave it to me today, and I'm so excited because I have been looking for a leather hat that like fit good for a long time, probably a year now. So I am like jacked that I have this hat. Okay, children of the 90s, is this not so Janet Jackson vibes? I love it. Luke's been napping for about an hour now, and I was just nursing Elizabeth for about an hour. We nurse and snuggle for the most part, almost the whole time that Luke naps right now, but I'm really, really enjoying that time, and I just rock her and nurse her and switch sides and close my eyes and kind of doze off for a little bit. So even though I never get to lay in my bed right now and nap, I still kind of take that time to rest, or sometimes I do a little work on my phone or on my computer, but for the most part I just rest when I'm doing that with her. So after that, then I'm like starving, so now I'm just eating leftover chicken fingers. Lizzie's just hanging out over here in her bouncy chair, watching me eat. We gave her food for the first time last night. We gave her some squash, and she liked it. We just gave her like the smallest little bites, but she liked it. She was definitely getting interested in us eating while we eat, so I think she's ready for it. But what I wanted to do right now really quickly is just share with you something that I've been really thinking about the last couple days, and something that I'm really grateful for. I'm not sure if you guys saw one of my most recent videos, the Good for the Soul tag video. I'm going to be talking about God's blessings in my life, or God's messages in my life, a little bit more often on my YouTube channel. So one of the things that I wanted to share in today's vlog was how God has an amazing plan for our life, and sometimes it doesn't always make sense, but He has a plan, and His plan is better than anything that I could ever plan for my life. So the reason this came to my mind is I was just praying yesterday, and I'm doing some writing right now for Wildfire Women, which I'll share more about later, but I am writing, and sometimes when I'm trying to write about my spiritual journey, I really have to meditate or pray about certain pieces of it until I can kind of really get my thoughts out, organized the way that I want them to be. So I'm just really rambling on here. I was giving it some thought yesterday about how I am where I am right now. And when I graduated high school, I started working full-time at Carol Baker Massage. And I loved my job, but there was a huge part of me that was very insecure about working full-time when all of my friends were going off to college and university. I felt like I was either taking the easy way out, or missing a step, or missing out on something. But yet, I really liked working, and I really liked the field that I was in. But I found it very difficult to be content where I was at. Now I can see, retrospect, years and years later, that God was laying a foundation for me to be able to stay home with my family and still work part-time and run my own business. So I was just so, so grateful to God for all of the education that He essentially put me through with my past careers to lead me to this point and to be able to start my own business and stay home with my family. So at times I felt like, you know, where is my life going? What am I doing wrong? Everybody else is doing something different. But now, because of that, I am where I am, and God knew my heart before I knew my heart, that I would have a heart that wanted to stay home with my children. And so He laid a foundation for me to be able to do that, and to have skill sets and tools and experience in an industry that would allow me to work a little bit and stay home with my family. So that was kind of my moment with God yesterday, and I just wanted to share that for anyone that is in a place right now where they're praying for resolution with something, and maybe you're not getting it. Maybe God has a bigger plan that we just can't understand, because there's definitely areas of my life right now that I don't fully understand, that I pray for understanding on, and God doesn't always answer those prayers right away. But knowing what He has done in my past gives me hope for right now, that if I just keep praying and staying in line with the direction He's leading me, then he will continue to, you know, take care of me and put me where I need to be ready for the next phase of my life and to be ready for the plan that he has for me that is so, so great. So I hope that little story gives you some peace if you're going through anything like that. Anyways, I'm gonna eat my chicken now, so. I like to dip my chicken in barbecue sauce and honey. What do you like to dip your chicken in? Sometimes I like to mix it. Sometimes I also like ranch. Let's face it, I like ranch on everything. I try not to eat it on everything, but I really like it. It's windy out today, but it's really mild. It's around 7 or 8 degrees. Yeah, so we're playing in the sand that we made yesterday with flour and baby oil. So you take 8 cups of flour and 1 cup of baby oil and mix it all together, and it's like this packable, soft sand. It's really cool. We played with it in the house yesterday and it got pretty messy, which was fine, but I thought today would be a good day to play with it outside. And I was not the person to think of this. My friend on Facebook posted a picture of her kids playing in this yesterday and the recipe, and I was excited because I had both things in the house, so we just went for it, didn't we, Luke? And it worked out pretty good. Lizzie, you want to come over and see what we're doing? You want to go over and sit by brother? Yeah, it's nice out, isn't it? Yeah. Look at you. Look at you, smart girl. Alright, I'm going to call it a day for today, put my PJs on, get cozied in. It's bachelor night, and I think I'm going to go live tonight when I'm doing my nightly skincare regime, because I'm going to be having a blog post go up tonight as well about my results from the Arbonne Genius Ultra, which you have to check it out. I will link all of the blog posts and videos below so you can see my experience and the amazing results that I've seen from the Arbonne Genius Ultra. It's so fabulous. So I think I'm gonna go live while I'm doing my nighttime routine on my Howl Makeup Artistry Facebook page and share that with the people there. So if you wanna check out that page, all my socials are always in the information box below my videos. So wherever you like to hang out, whether it's Instagram, Snapchat, Facebook. You can find all of those links below. Thanks for hanging out with me and coming along on my day with me. I always love hearing from you. Give me your thoughts in the comments below, and I'll see you in my next video. Thanks for watching. Bye.